Hey, how's it going, guys? This is Eckyman, and welcome back to The Binding of Isaac. And we are doing some more greed runs today. And we're gonna do Eve, I think. Sorry if you're a bit sick of the greed runs, but I just want to get all of this done. I will take a look at some challenges soon as well. Speed up, size down, I'm fine with that. Wait, did that drop something as well? I thought it dropped something. Obviously not. Wait, well, I'm buying a key. Let's go take a look in here. Oh, come on. I don't want this item at all. It's a fire rate up, but it's a damage down. And it applies to all damage ups you get after this point as well. Alright, well, smart thing to do here would be activate Whore of Babylon. There we go. Pick these soul hearts up. And let's do this. So, Whore of Babylon activates at a single red heart, gives me increased speed and damage, and it alters Eve's damage multiplier to something you can actually work with. So all of the characters it activates at a half red heart. Eve's the only one that it changes for. Yep. Speed up's pretty nice. So we are ideally going to want to try and stay at a single red heart if we can. Which means we're going to need quite a lot of soul hearts. Oh, we've got another wave coming in as well. Mind you, dead bird's putting in work. Oh! Walked myself right into that. I find it much harder to avoid damage in greed mode. I don't think the mode is actually too hard, but I seem to end up walking into damage quite a lot. That is terrible. I don't want any of this stuff at all. I mean, I guess I'll take the health up. Oh, why did I do that? Now I don't have Aura Babylon active. Oh well, we'll make it work. We'll make it work. And I will probably buy a lump of coal, assuming I get enough money out of this, which I should do. But yeah, my damage is pretty bad right now. I think Eve has... Is it a 0.8 damage multiplier? So... A 0.8. Something like that. Anyway, we do less damage than everyone else. Eve does less damage than everyone else. I want to clear you before I start focusing on Pin, because you're a real pain. You know that, right? Come on, dead bird. Put some work in. There we go. Right, so now I need to clear you. Right, now we can focus on Pin. There we go, and we've got 15 cents, so I'm definitely buying the lump of coal. And how I wish I could buy synth oil. Is this double pin or wretched? No, it's double pin. Not wretched. What's the name of the skeleton version of this? I always forget. Anyway, whatever. It's a double pin, so it's easy enough to do. Lump of coal is really going to help. Increases my damage based on how far our tiers travel. Might have already said that. Not what I wanted to see. Actually, I might get Head of Krampus for this. This could be pretty good, actually. No, I should get Head of Krampus for this because I already have Lump of Coal. So ideally, I would want to let all waves spawn and then wreck them with the Head of Krampus. kind of a pain having these things in the middle. Yeah, I'll take that then. Right, so I can't really do anything else. No. Okay, moving on. Yeah, I'm not going to be able to spawn everything in one go, and I'll take little Steven. Familiar follows me around, fires homing tears. Definitely going to be buying Squeezy. And Hive Mind, I guess. Alright, so let's see if we can do this. Maybe we can do it. Certainly not on every floor, but actually these green guys are going to do a lot of my work for me as well, aren't they? Alright, so I'm going to use this now. Wow, it actually turns around. That's weird. I mean, I know that happens with the Krampus fight, but I didn't know they'd changed the head of Krampus to do that. Interesting. Settle down, fellas. So ideally we need items that are going to give us soul hearts, because, yeah. So I'm going to take this now, and not pick up the, really only one soul heart, you're supposed to get two, what's that about? I'm a little confused at that. Oh, okay, right, so let's take some damage here, there we go. Grab these, grab that, and let's do the boss wave. Now ideally we would find something like magic mushroom so I can actually get a 1.5 damage multiplier and I don't have to rely on the Power of Babylon mode. That's ideal. Or that would be ideal, I should say, sorry. Definitely gonna buy you. And a key. Yeah, okay, I'll buy that. I'll buy that, I'm not buying it. Yeah, charm tears anyway. Has a chance of charming enemies so they fight each other. And of course we have angel rooms active because we didn't take a deal with the devil. Yep, that's about all we can do, so let's get out of here. I don't want the health. Alright, let's go. Yeah, chopsticks. Let's tears up. And a shot speed up, but mainly I'm interested in the tears up. Yeah. Not a great selection of items. Oh, and I could just skip this floor altogether, which obviously we don't want to do. Look in here. Balls of steel? Nope. Balls of steel? Nope. Alright, let's do this. What am I missing? There we go. Right, well, this wave could be worse. These guys are more time-consuming than difficult to deal with, so... it's all good. So obviously we're going to buy a key. Yeah, checkpoint 5, I'm down with that. So it's going to give me a chance of firing a laser. Yeesh. Certainly not a good selection of items in this shop. Go for another reroll. Ah, oh, chaos would be good, but... all stats up. Probably better. I'll take it. Gives me a health up though, which I could have done without. Buy the key. You should really wait until the next floor before you buy a key, just in case there is a 3-cent key. Kind of obnoxious guy, why don't you hang around a bit and get shot? There we go. Nope, okay, fine. Oh yeah, okay, well, definitely gotta take that. And then if I'm smart, I should do this, and then this. And then that gives me 3 sin hearts to work with. Yeah. So that's okay. I'm actually pretty pleased with that. Not leaving anything behind? No. Right, let's go, go, go. Right, so now our build's reasonably good. Yeah, I'll take that. Mom's eye, chance of firing. I'm going to take this. Still gives me Horror Babylon active. Obviously I want that. Let's have a look in here. I don't have any bombs, so that was a waste. I did buy Hive Mind, right? Yeah, so my flies are doing additional damage right now. Which is awesome. Okay, so, yep, we're buying damage and HP up. Where did you guys come from? I lose Horror Babylon, but I'm hoping I can get it reactivated, as long as there's something good to take from the Devil Room here. Wow, I'm really throwing health away now. Boss is always a pain. There we go. 12 cents. We're on wound one. Yes, yeah, so I need a key for the next floor. Let's buy that. I guys are gonna fight each other briefly. Okay, that was stupid. I've got one guppy item. I'm gonna buy Guppy's collar. Hope for another guppy item. I've got no soul hearts in there, that's fine. No tinted rocks. There is a tinted rock actually. Can I buy a bomb? No. Probably wouldn't be worth the money anyway. Oh well, let's just get on the next floor and hopefully we've got something good in here. Nails. Look up. Plus two keys. Thing is, I really want to keep my... I really want to keep my scythes, and I'm not sure what effect that will have on my scythes. Pretty fly, orbital, box tears. Does a small amount of damage to, does damage to flies, but nothing else. Contact damage to flies, I should say. Alright, what can we get? I don't want any of this. All that. I suppose PhD. Totally wasn't really worth it, honestly. This is wound shawl, so I don't have an item on the next floor, so I'm gonna do this. Grab that bomb, and if I get enough money, maybe we can get a free reroll going. This should be easy enough to deal with. Really could have used a guppy item, honestly. Okay, what do we have in here? BFF could be good. But I'm going to take Chaos. Makes you larger, not interested. Yeah, sure, I'll use this. What was this item? Yeah, nails. I'm going to leave that. But I will try and find out if it does have any effect on scythes. I assume you'd still keep piercing. I don't know though. And there's a guppy item. Excellent, that's what I want to see. So, let's do this. Can't really afford the curse room, so that's not happening. Whoa! How did that not damage me? I just got super lucky with that, right? Must have done. Yeah, so we buy you. And potentially get rid of my health. Let's do this. So I've got flight now, and every tier that lands spawns a kamikaze fly, which is pretty good. Yeah, so okay, we do this one first. See if we've got anything good in here. Well, I'll take that, and I'll take blood clot. And then the smart thing to do would be to buy raw leather, which gives me 2 health. Then use Guppy's paw twice. I've still got 6 cents to donate. 9 cents to donate, so that's not bad. Right, let's go, go, go. So we should be in a good position to beat Ultra Greed here, I think. Steam cell. Okay. So we're going to do a lot of upfront damage here as all the flies pile in. No, I'm not actually too much there. Doing okay though. I think I've fought this boss too much today. I've been recording all these episodes in the same day, and I'm a little bit sick of this boss, to be honest. I mean, it's still fun. It's different, but I don't know. It's not. I feel it can be more cheap than challenging, you know? Alright, and we are done. Blackfeather has appeared in the basement. Where's my donation machine? Oh, it's right there. I'm not sure. I assume this will go up to 999. I don't know. Anyway, it took all our money, so that's good. And that is another character down for greed mode, which is awesome. Alright, well, that's going to do us for today, guys. As always, really hope you've enjoyed watching this. I'm out for now, and I will see you soon with some more of The Binding of Isaac. Peace!